Hi students, in this video we will discuss some problems here. That is the question number 9. In rectangle triangle ABC at B, if tan is equal to 1 by root 3, find the value of two different subbits. Here sin A and cos A plus cos A sin C, second bit cos A, cos C minus sin A, cos A. You observe here in these two bits, angle is at A and also angle is at C. So let us consider right angle triangle at B. So I am taking one right angle triangle ABC. So this is A, this is B, this is C. This is one right angle triangle at B. This is completely at B. This is the angle is 90 degrees. And angle is present at A. Because according to problem, if tan A is equal to 1 by root 3, angle is at A. So now, this is the opposite side. Opposite side. This is the adjacent side. Exactly 90 degrees opposite to this AC side. This is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. Now, given condition, given tan A is equal to 1 by root 3. Tan A is equal to 1 by root 3. What is the meaning of this one? Tan A, nothing but the opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side by adjacent side. What is opposite side value? 1. Opposite side is 1. Adjacent side value is root 3. Adjacent side root 3. Now we don't know hypotenuse side. We have to find out hypotenuse side by using Pythagoras theorem. By using Pythagoras theorem, find out hypotenuse value. So AC square is equal to side square AB square plus BC square. AB square plus BC square. Here AC square is equal to what is AB side? That is root 3 whole square plus BC side is 1 square. So now AC square is equal to square root, cancel this one, 3 plus 1, that is 4. So AC is equal to root 4, which is equal to 2. So AC side is, that is hypotenuse, that is 2. Hypotenuse 2, opposite side value 1, adjacent side is root 3. Now, when the angle is at A, this is BC side is opposite side and AB side is adjacent side. Now, I am finding sin A value. Sin A is equal to, according to angle A, sin A is nothing but, what is the formula? Sin A is opposite side by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. What is opposite side? BC side is opposite side. That is 1 by hypotenuse value is 2 sin A. Next find out cos A. Cos A is equal to cos A formula, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse, which is equal to adjacent side is root 3 divided by hypotenuse side is equal to 2. Adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is equal to root 3 by 2. Why we are finding only sin A cos A? According to two bits, sin A value and again cos A value. Here also cos A and again sin A. You have to find. Already this one completed. Now I am finding sin C. When angle is at C, when angle is at C, angle is at C, this is clearly hypotenuse, that is clear. Exactly 90 degrees opposite to this side, this is hypotenuse side. When angle is at C, this is the opposite side. This is the opposite side. And this is the adjacent side. BC side is adjacent side. When angle is at C, remember, when angle is at A, this is clearly adjacent side, this is opposite side. When angle is at C, exactly opposite to C, to AB side, this is opposite side. And exactly adjacent, that means beside to this BC side, this is adjacent side. So now sin C formula is opposite side by hypotenuse. which is equal to what is opposite side? Root 3. So root 3 divided by hypotenuse value is 2. Next, find out cos C. Cos C is equal to, again same thing, adjacent side by hypotenuse, which is equal to what is adjacent side here? BC side is the adjacent side, that is 1 by hypotenuse value is 2. So remember, we have completed 4 values, sin A, cos A, according to angle A, according to angle A, we have completed sin A and again cos A. According to angle C, the triangle ABC, angle is at C, we have completed sin C and again cos C. These are the 4 values. Now coming to the first bit. What is the first bit here? Sin A, cos C, plus cos A, sin C, which is equal to, what is sin A value? Sin A value 1 by 2. Cos C value also 1 by 2, plus cos A value root 3 by 2 into cos A value root 3 by 2 into sin C value is root 3 by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, that is 1 by 4, plus root 3 by 2 into root 3 by 2, whole square, that is root 3 by 2 whole square, which is equal to 1 by 4 plus square root cancel, that is 3 by 2 square, that is 4, which is equal to 1 plus 3, 4, 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. So first bit answer is 1. Coming to the second bit, what is the second bit? Value is cos A, cos C minus sin A, sin C. Which is, what is cos A value? Already completed cos A value, root 3 by 2 into cos C value. What is cos C value? 1 by 2 minus sin A. What is sin A? 1 by 2 into sin C value, root 3 by 2. So now, this is one term, but both values are same. So you can write as root 3 into 1, root 3 divided by 2 into 2, 4, minus root 3 into 1, root 3 divided by 2, 2's are 4, both are same, you can cancel, this answer becomes 0. So now we have completed according to the problem, right angle at B, and again, we have to find out sin A and again cos A at angle A. Next one, at angle C, identify sin C and again cos C and substitute those 4 values in 2 bits, you will get the answer, right? So now, next concept, trigonometric ratios of some specific angles, means here we have to find out the 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45, 60 and again 90 degrees. These 0 to 90 degrees values we have to identify for the particular trigonometric ratios. So now, concept is trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. So now, in this trigonometric ratios, total we have 6 trigonometric ratios. For the specific angles, means here 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. I will do some angles values. Similarly, we can find out yourself. So now, first one, trigonometric ratio of 45 degrees. First, I am finding trigonometric ratio of 45 degree. So, I want to sin 45, cos 45, tan 45, secant, cosecant, and again cot. 6 trigonometric ratios of the angle 45 degrees. Before that, I am taking triangle ABC is a right angle triangle and also it is a isosceles triangle. See, this is one right angle triangle ABC at angle 90 degrees and also it is a isosceles triangle. Let triangle ABC is a right angle isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle ABC is a right angle isosceles triangle. So now for the isosceles triangle, only two sides are equal, AB side and again BC side, and right angle is at position is B, that is 90 degrees. Remaining two sides are must be same, that is this is 45 degrees and again this is also 45 degrees. Isosceles right angle triangle, two sides equal and again two angles are also equal. So clearly here angle A is equal to angle C. Angle A is equal to angle C because this is 90 degrees. The remaining two sides are 45 degrees, and again two sides are equal. AB side and again BC side also equal. Therefore, let us say AB is equal to BC side. Therefore, AB is equal to BC side. Two sides are equal. For suppose, let AB side is I am taking A. BC side is also A. AB equal to BC is equal to A. Let us consider AB is equal to BC is equal to A. By using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square, we don't know hypotenuse square. Already AB side, BC side equal. We have taken, consider the value AB and BC value is equal to A. So now, we have to find out hypotenuse value by using Pythagoras theorem. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So AC square is equal to AB square value, A square plus BC also A square. So AC square is equal to 2A square. AC is equal to square root 2A square. That is nothing but root is applicable for both values. Root 2 into A. Root 2 into A. So now hypotenuse value root 2 into A, so not in the full root, root 2 into A. So this is hypotenuse AC side value root 2 into A. So now I want to find out sine 40, remaining 6 trigonometric ratios, sine 45, cos 45, tan 45, all the values. So when the angle is present at A, sine A is nothing but here angle is what we are taking 45 degrees. Sine 45 degrees is equal to, sine 45 degrees is equal to, see, according to the angle A, angle is A, this BC side is the opposite side, this is adjacent side, this is the hypotenuse. This is the hypotenuse. So now angle A is nothing but angle is present at A, that is the value is 45 degrees. So sine 45 degrees, which is equal to opposite side. Opposite side value how much? That is BC divided by, this is BC side, opposite side, this is a hypotenuse, this is the adjacent side. BC divided by hypotenuse, that is AC. So BC side value how much? So A divided by AC value is root 2 into A. AA get cancelled, we will get 1 by root 2. Sine 45 degrees value is 1 by root 2. So next one, cos 45 degrees. Cos 45 degrees. Here A is nothing but 45 degrees, remember. So A is, I want cos 45 degrees. Cos 45 degrees nothing but what? This is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side, and this is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. So now cos 45 degrees, adjacent side. What is adjacent side? AB divided by, AB divided by hypotenuse, that is AC. AB divided by AC, that is A divided by AC value is root 2 into A. AA gets cancelled, again 1 by root 2. Next, tan 45 degrees. Tan 45 degrees nothing but what? Opposite side upon adjacent side. Opposite side. What is opposite side? BC divided by adjacent side AB, which is equal to BC side value is A, and also AB side is also A. According to AB side and BC side both are equal. So these two are cancelled, you will get 1, A divided by A, that is 1. So now, I want cot 45 degrees. Cot 45 degrees means what? Cot is always reciprocal of tan. Cot is always reciprocal of tan. So now, we can write as AB divided by BC, reciprocal. So A by A, which is also 1. Next, cosecant 45 degrees. So cosecant 45 degrees, which is equal to, cosecant 45 means what? Cosecant is the trigonometric ratio, which is the reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine means, that is hypotenuse divided by opposite side, that is AC divided by BC, which is equal to root 2 A by A. A cancel, you get root 2. So 1 by root 2 reciprocal, root 2 by 1, that is 1 by root 2. Next, secant 45 degrees, which is equal to, secant is always reciprocal of cos. So that is hypotenuse by adjacent side, AC divided by AB, which is equal to root 2 A by A, which is also root 2. So secant and again cosecant values are same. Yes, sine cos values are same. Tan cot values are same according to the trigonometric ratios of 45 degrees. So now second one, trigonometric ratios of 30 degrees and 60 degrees. Already 45 degrees over. I am doing second type, that is 30 degrees and 60 degrees. How to find sine 30, cos 30, tan 30, secant, cosecant, and again cot 30. At the same time remaining sin 60, cos 60, tan 60, secant, cosecant, cot 60. These values how to find. So here I am taking one equilateral triangle. ABC is a one equilateral triangle. ABC is a one equilateral triangle. ABC is one equilateral triangle. So now this is A, B, or C. ABC is one equilateral triangle. Or simply you can take, this is A or B or C. That is rubbish. A, B, C is one equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means three sides are equal. From A, you can draw one line, perpendicular line, to the side BC. This is perpendicular line, and also it is altitude, and also it is median. This is the perpendicular bisector to the side BC. So ABD, let us take this is D. A, draw one perpendicular line, AD is on the side BC. So now ABD and again ABC, these two triangles are similar triangles. So now here in the equilateral triangle, AB, BC and AC, three sides are equal. So let us consider this is the side is 2A. Let us consider BC side is 2A and again AC side is 2A, AB side is also 2A. Why we are taking 2A? D is the line, D is the point, divides BC. So BD and again CD both are equal. This is A and this is A. So BD is equal to DC. BD is always half of the part of BC. This is A, total side BC is equal to 2A. So now we have to find out AD. So ABC is one right angle triangle. We have to find out remaining all three sides. That means 30 degrees and again 60 degrees values. So in the equilateral triangle, this is the 60 degrees. Each angle is 60 degrees, right? This is 60 degrees, this is also 60 degrees, and again this A side is clearly 60 degrees, but it divided into two parts, so it is 30 degrees. This is also 30 degrees, so 30 plus 30, 60 degrees. Angle A is at 60 degrees. So now let triangle ABC is a equilateral triangle. So now angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 60 degrees. A, B, C having 60 degrees. And also for the equilateral triangle, BD is equal to DC. BD is equal to DC. Why it is BD is equal to DC? Here triangle, before that, here triangle, right angle triangle, A, B, D is always similarly equal to the right angle triangle A, D, C. A B D right angle triangle A D B triangle A D B is similarly equal to the right angle triangle A B C. So these two triangles are similar triangles. Clearly B D is equal to C D. B D is equal to C D. So now B D is equal to C D. So I am considering triangle from the triangle from the triangle ADC from the triangle ADC ADC BC is equal to 2A angle BC is equal to 2A then why it is BC is equal to A we have to find out BD is equal to BD is equal to half into half of the part of BC so that is equal to half into 2A which is equal to A 2 2 gets cancelled A so BD is clearly A BC side is half of the part of BC it is clearly A so from the right angle triangle from the right angle triangle using Pythagoras theorem from the right angle triangle ADC using Pythagoras theorem I want to find AD side so this is the AC square is equal to AD square plus CD square so AC square value 2A whole square which is equal to AD side value what is AD side we don't know we have to find out AD side and again CD value is equal to A square so 4A square minus A square is equal to AD square this A square will take this side so it is clearly 3A square is equal to AD square So AD is equal to square root of 3A square. So clearly AD is equal to root 3 into A. So AD side value is root 3 into A. This is clearly root 3A. This is the, when compared to the angle 60 degrees, this side AD side is opposite side and this is adjacent side. This is the hypotenuse from the triangle ADC. Remember ADB and again ADC both are similar triangles. Clearly BD is equal to CD. BD is equal to CD. When BC side is 2A, it is clearly this is A but this is A. And find the remaining all trigonometries of 30 degrees and again 60 degrees. 30 and 60 degrees. So now we have to find out the sine 30, cos 30, tan 30 degrees and again secant 30, cosecant 30 and again cot 30. Remaining 60 degrees values also we have to find out sine 60, cos 60, tan 60, secant 30, secant 60, cosecant 60 and again cot 60 values. So now we have to find out rest of the values. So now according to the diagram, this is 30 degrees, this is 60 degrees. We have to find out separately 30 degrees and 60 degrees. So first one sine A. Here A is nothing but see not A. You can take sine A which is equal to sine 30 degrees value. How to find sine 30 degrees value? When angle is at 30 degrees, angle A is 30 degrees. This is opposite side. This is the adjacent side. This is the hypotenuse value. Opposite side. Value opposite side is nothing but when angle is 30 degrees. See, observe only ADC triangle. Angle A is 30 degrees. We can write as sine 30 is nothing but opposite side. Opposite side is how much? That is CD divided by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse value is AC, which is equal to CD value A by AC value. That is 2A, which is equal to 1 by 2. Next one, cos 30 degrees. Cos 30 degrees means what? Adjacent side. Adjacent side is that is AD. AD divided by hypotenuse value is AC, which is equal to AD value is root 3 divided by A by AC value is 2A, which is equal to root 3 by 2. Next one, tan 30 degrees. Tan 30 degrees value means opposite side divided by opposite side. This is the, remember, this is the hypotenuse. This is the opposite side. This is the adjacent side. Compared to only ADC triangle. Tan 30, opposite side value CD divided by adjacent side value is AD. So which is equal to a divided by root 3a, which is equal to 1 by root 3a, a cancel, so you will get 1 by root 3. I want cot 30 degrees, nothing but what cot 30 degrees? Reciprocal of tan. Reciprocal of tan means ad divided by cd, which is equal to root 3. 1 by root 3 changes as root 3 by 1. Next one, cosecant 30. Cosecant 30 degrees value is equal to reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine means how much? AC divided by CD, which is equal to 2 by 1, which is equal to 2. Next one, secant 30 degrees value. Secant 30 means what? Reciprocal of cos 30 degrees. That is AC divided by AD, which is equal to 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3. So reciprocal of cos means that is root 3 by 2 is given, that is clearly 2 by root 3. Next, coming to the secant. But 60 degrees values. 60 degrees value means what? Sin A, which is equal to sin 60 degrees. Sin 60 degrees. When the angle is present at C, that is the value angle at C, that is clearly 60 degrees. 60 degrees means what? Sin 60 value. Now, this is the opposite side. This is opposite side. This is hypotenuse. This is adjacent side. This is adjacent side. When compared to the angle C, this is opposite side, this is adjacent side, this is hypotenuse. Sin 60 is equal to opposite side value, that is AD divided by hypotenuse, AD by AC, that is root 3A by AC value is 2A, which is equal to root 3 divided by 2, 2A cancel. So now, cos 60 degrees, cos 60 degrees means what? Adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is CD divided by AC, which is equal to A by AC value is 2A. AA cancel, you will get 1 by 2. Next one, tan 60 degrees. Tan 60 degrees means what? Tan 60 degree value is opposite side by adjacent side. That is AD divided by CD. AD value is root 3A by CD value A. So AA cancel, you will get tan 60 degree value is root 3. Next one, cosecant 60 degrees. Cosecant 60 degrees means reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine means what? AC by AD, which is equal to root 3 divided by, that is reciprocal of sine means that is 2 by root 3. So next one, secant 60 degree. Secant 60 degree means what? Secant 60 degree. Secant 60 degree means here, secant 60. Reciprocal of cos, that is AC divided by CD, which is equal to 2 by 1, that is equal to 2, reciprocal of cos. Next one, cot 60 degree. Cot 60 degree means what? Cot 60 degree, reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse, CD by AD, that is equal to 1 by root 3. CD value is A by root 3a, that is 1 by root 3. Reciprocal of this value is equal to 1 by root 3. Remember, when the angle is A, we are taking 30 degrees, and again when the angle C, that is 60 degrees. See, I am considering only right angle triangle ADC. Angle is present at 30, AA, that is 30 degrees. When the angle is at C, sin C, C is nothing but here 60 degrees. Sin 60, cos 60, tan 60, cosecant and secant, and again cot 60. These are the trigonometric ratios of 45 degrees, 30 degrees and 60 degrees. Remaining 0 degrees, 90 degrees, you can try yourself. So in the next class, we will do for the table, how to remember the all the 6 trigonometric ratios of the values, value 0 to 90 degrees. We will discuss next class.